I have here three mirror galvanometers. Now, a galvanometer is an instrument for detecting and measuring electrical current, and it's based on a principle first discovered in 1820 by Hans Christian Ørsted, a Danish physicist, that current flowing through a wire could deflect a magnetic needle. The mirror galvanometer was invented by Professor William Thomson, later Sir William Thomson, later still Lord Kelvin, in 1858 in response to a practical and commercial need. Around that time, starting from 1857, there were attempts to lay a telegraph cable across the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean to connect Great Britain and America. Now, in doing so, because of the length of the cable and the fact that it was underwater, they came across a couple of problems of attenuation and capacitance. When you sent a signal from one end, at the other end it would come out stretched and elongated and essentially unintelligible. And when you send multiple signals, they would run into one another, and you'd end up with this sort of blurry noise that you couldn't make any sense out of. It wasn't particularly useful for telegraphy, which relied on concise, discrete electrical impulses. Thomson thought that the solution to this problem was to have a more sensitive detector at the other end. Basically, you have a coil of wire in the middle of which was a mirror with magnets attached to the back of it. Now, when the current ran through the coil, it deflected the magnets and twisted the mirror. So when you shone a light on it, the light reflected off onto a scale that was set up facing the galvanometer. And the when current came through the wire, the mirror would move such that you could see the light spot moving on the scale, and you could detect and measure that current. I have here my completely authentic and not at all anachronistic light source, and you'll see that if I shine this here at the mirror, there it is, you'll see that if I move the magnet up here, the permanent magnet, that the mirror turns one way back to the center and turns the other way. This magnet was used to center the mirror. Now, later on, Thomson and other inventors would attach the mirror to a coil of wire and suspend it between magnets instead. And this is most likely what these instruments are, the principle that they work on. These mirror galvanometers date from around the turn of the last century, the early 1900s, and they would have been used in local Yorkshire schools to teach children about physics. Now, the interesting thing about the mirror galvanometer in general as an instrument is that it was devised partly because there was a commercial need for an instrument that would do a certain job, but it then contributed to electrical science, because once you had an instrument as sensitive as this, you could detect smaller electric currents and you could measure more accurately what you were working with. So the galvanometer, the mirror galvanometer, is a very good example of an instrument devised for potentially commercial purpose, but which then went on to benefit scientific understanding of that which it detected. I want to actually finish off by giving you a sense of the awe and wonder that Thomson's instrument inspired in the 19th century by just giving you a bit of a poem by James Clerk Maxwell, the famous physicist who wrote this about Thomson's marvellous instrument. The lamplight falls on blackened walls and streams through narrow perforations. The long beam trails over pasteboard scales with slow decaying oscillations. Flow, current, flow, set the quick light spot flying. Flow, current, answer, light spot, flashing, quivering, dying.